Chris Bennett was a member of the Canadian Olympic and World Cup teams between 1973 and 1977. He had 6 international caps and 4 Olympic appearances during that time. He made 31 appearances in the original NASL, playing for the Vancouver Whitecaps, Seattle Sounders, and Memphis Rogues. With his playing days over, he turned to coaching and was the assistant coach of the Canadian National Under-17 team in 1989, the Canadian National Under-20 team from 1993 to 1997, the interim assistant coach of the Men's World Cup team in 1988, the assistant coach of the Pan American Games in 1999, the assistant coach of the Men's Olympic team from 1998 to 2000, and the head coach of the National Under-15 team in 1999 to 2000. As the assistant coach with the Under-20 team, he won the gold medal at the CONCACAF Finals in Mexico. In 2007, he was the head coach of the Vancouver Whitecaps women's team that was inducted into the British Columbia Sports Hall of Fame as champions of the North American Women's League. 2014 Builder Inductee, Chris Bennett.
Ladies and gentlemen, the first builder in that category this evening is indeed Chris Bennett.
Thank you for that wonderful introduction. Tonight, I'm feeling very honored because I'm now alongside my good friends, my teammates, and colleagues, past and present. I'm now a member of the Hall of Fame. I feel so proud. I'm also so grateful for how this game has blessed my life, and I would do it all over again. If I get a chance to, perhaps another day, you never know, I'd like to do it all over again. I was first a player, and then I transitioned into coaching. It was great to be a player, it's great to be a coach, but it's very hard on our spouses at times, because the game can engulf you. And you know what, you can't, if you want to reach the highest level in the game, there's no such thing as half measures. I would like to, at this time, to thank my wife, Anna Marie, for her patience and allowing me to pursue my passion in life. If I could still play, I wouldn't coach. But I always knew that I would coach after I finished playing. My coaching profile changed when a good friend of mine, Bruce Twomley, phoned me one day many years ago and asked me if I would consider working with him up at Simon Fraser University at the new National Training Center. I'm sure Les Wilson had something to do with that phone call. Bruce and I were inseparable. For almost 14 years, we were together 5 times a week. It was a perfect match. It was almost like a Cluffy Taylor scenario. We could just look at each other and we'd know what the other one was thinking. It was that, we were that tight. And I found him so easy to work with. And my time working with the national program for those 14 years were some of the best memories of my life. We had a lot of good laughs, didn't we, Kevin? Hey. We always had the best staff, and we felt confident and comfortable with each other. We were cautious, but I can tell you now, I was never afraid going into competition, never, because I felt so comfortable with the people that I was surrounded by. We had Les Wilson, our manager, behind-the-scenes leader all the time. Total support. We had Kevin Muldoon. The name speaks for itself. We had the late, great Dr. Rudy Gittins, who was in a class of his own. We had Greg Bay and other people that filled in at times when those people couldn't be there. And of course, we had our wonderful hand-picked players. We were always well-prepared. We were always well-organized. And boy, did we have a special time there for a while. Many of the players that Bruce and I coached and our staff worked with are here tonight being honored as a team in the team of distinction category. I believe there's 9 of them that are on this team of distinction from Bruce's group. Being here tonight amongst all these fine individuals, players, and teams has made me extremely proud. I would like to thank everyone involved with the Hall of Fame for making this a special night. This is really a special time in our lives, and I did not know it was going to be of the quality of tonight. It's been amazing so far, and having to follow these other people, it's a tall order. I'd like to thank the Hall of Fame for thinking I'm worthy as well to be inducted into the Hall of Fame. Thank you all for sharing this special occasion with me. Thank you very much.
Congratulations on being inducted into the Canadian Soccer Hall of Fame. Memories, great moments,
Yes. Everything
flowing through your mind tonight. Up Yes. There in that speech, it was so lovely to hear you thank so many. But what was important is you told us the path. You played the game, you worked in it, and now you want to give back. Talk about it.
Well, it's just that, there's nothing like playing the game. Once you've played, there's nothing will ever come close to that. But the second best thing you can do once you finish playing is coach. And I always knew I was a student of the game even when I was a player. I always knew that eventually when I finished playing, I was going to coach. I coached all through the senior leagues in Vancouver, and I get a phone call maybe about 16, 17 years ago. It asked me if I wanted to go into the national training program up at Simon Fraser University and work with national level athletes. I was up there for 14 years with Bruce Twomley. 14 of the best coaching years of my life. Tonight in the team of distinction, there was 9 of our players were on that in that team of distinction there, 9 of our young boys that came through the system.
What is something that stands out still to you to this day, Chris, that you'll never forget as a player and then in the administrative part?
Well, as a player, I think I had a job to do against Poland at Varsity Stadium way back in the 70s. And the great Temerczewski was in goal. And I caught Temerczewski flat-footed from about 40 yards out and buried it in the bottom corner. I don't even think he saw it coming. And we didn't win the game. We lost the game 3-1, but that was the third best team in the world at the time. And the goal I scored against him was a cracker. As far as coaching goes, the top of the pyramid for me was when we went to Mexico and we beat Mexico for the gold medal in Mexico. And I think we're the first team in history to ever do that. Nobody's beaten Mexico for the gold medal in Mexico. And we did that. And also, I coached the Whitecaps women to the W League Championship. But it was an undefeated season. We never lost a single game in the whole season. And that I don't think anybody's going to touch that one. Because to go undefeated, you cannot afford a single mistake the whole year long, eh?
Chris, coast to coast in this great country of ours, Canada, we have so many wonderful, talented athletes, women and men, but we still are struggling in the men's department getting back to the World Cup.
Yep.
You've played, you've coached, you've seen it all. In your memory, in your mind right now, what has to happen for us to get back to the World Cup?
Well, there needs to be a bridge. And right now what we have is a system in place where the children or the players go through to a certain level and then they come to a cul-de-sac and they're not sure what to do. Some players are late bloomers. There's players in the past that didn't get selected, like a Peter Beardsley didn't get selected till he was later on in life. And Kevin Keegan didn't get selected till later on in life. And we've got to bridge the gap between when they're finished juvenile and between Toronto FC and Vancouver Whitecaps. There has to be a gap, a serious gap, where these kids are trained on a regular basis, maybe 6 days a week, and they're learning about all the tactics and all the techniques and all the nutrition and all the health consciousness they need to know, and let them, and maybe loan them out to a pro club and give them the opportunity to say, like, I went to Arsenal for a period of time. I went to Chelsea for a period of time. Maybe we've got to farm these players out and give them the experience to these world-class teams. That's what we did years ago. And you need to have people in place who know the players inside out. Years ago, I could make one phone call to Kevin Muldoon and I could say, what's going on in Ontario? Tell me who the best center back is right now, about 16 or 17 years of age. He could tell me. And he might say Jason Bent, because there's an example of somebody he told me about. Paul Stoltari, another one he told me about. Young Dwayne Duriggiero, another one he told me about. Robbie Aristimito, another one he told me about.
Jim Larkin, another one he told me about. Jim Brennan, another one he told me about. These are not mistakes. These are people making decisions on players because they know the players inside out, they know the character of the players, and they know that these are the type of players that need to take the next step into the national level. That's why our success level at the U20s, when Bruce and myself and Kevin and Les and the doctors and the medical staff, we were getting success. We got the bronze medal in Honduras, we got the gold medal in Mexico, and we got 13th in the world in the Malaysian World Cup. People don't know that. We were 13th in the world in the Malaysian World Cup. Wow. We were. And I've got the FIFA describing how Canada played. And they couldn't believe who was Argentina and who was Canada when we were playing. We had a good side. And my women's team, Whitecaps women, were 7th in the world.
Chris, well said. Very quickly before we let you go, you know, we're both proud Canadians. I have Italian heritage, and in my home I've always said my two boys, if Canada ever were to play Italy in a friendly World Cup game, it would be a dream of mine. I would support Canada through and through till the end. In this country, unfortunately, we don't have too many people like yourself and me that support Canada before the old country. How does that need to change?
Well, this has been going on since Adam was a boy. 1973, we played Poland at Varsity Stadium. We lost 3-1. The crowd were cheering for Poland. Okay, that was 73. Today, I think if there was Poland was playing here again, they would still be cheering for Poland. I think we can talk a lot here, but the Americans are, I think beat the drum better than we do.
Oh yeah.
You know, and it was only a matter of time for the Americans to start doing what they're doing now, which is dominating in CONCACAF and all that sort of thing. But we need to become more nationalistic. Yes. We need to stick by our players. We need to stick by the people in charge. We need to support the players in charge as much as possible. But we still need to bridge that gap because the kids are coming out of juvenile and there's a big space between juvenile and the Whitecaps and Toronto FC.
Chris Bennett, congratulations being inducted into the Soccer Hall of Fame.
Thank you very much.
You're a proud Canadian. More people like Chris we need across this country. Congratulations once again, Chris.
It's my pleasure. I had a wonderful night, and I'm so proud.
Chris Bennett, Hall of Fame inductee.